How's it going, everybody? This is Tabo Drabo. Hope you're having another great day, and welcome back to another video. I have not done this in such a long time, but I'm bringing it back today. It's time for another classical conversation. In this series, I'll talk about everything about classical music, its importance, its history, and why it is important in today's world. So everything in regards to classical music, we talk about here in this series. And for today's topic, I want to talk about metalheads, and especially if they can get involved in classical music. Now, I know that this is more of a genre that is more specified towards, you know, the older generations, you know, like, you know, the Gen X, and, you know, like the baby boomers and all that stuff, but they're usually not very well known to younger generations. But there's also a specific genre of music fans that, you know, would not really associate themselves that much with this genre. So I'm going to talk a little bit about metal and rock and whether people in that genre can specifically become fans of classical music. Now, for those that know me, my preferred genre in music is the rock and metal genre. I usually love that genre. It is actually my favorite genre of music. And the reason why is because there's just a lot of intensity when it comes to the music that's played in that particular genre. And it really doesn't matter what it is. You know, it can be like pop punk or like punk rock or maybe even just regular hard rock or alternative rock or heck, maybe even the hardest kinds of rock, like the metal genre, like for example, alternative metal or maybe even industrial progressive metal or heck, maybe even metalcore. There are so many fans of this particular genre, and literally anybody of today's generation, you know, whether it's Gen X or even millennials or Gen Zs, they can get involved in this particular genre as fans. But the thing is that unlike most other genres, you know, like with pop or R&B, you know, stuff like that, metal in particular, they aren't usually associated with classical music that much because, you know, most metalheads, you know, they aren't really those that are more into like the soft tone kind of music, you know. They are more into, you know, the head banging and, you know, like the real metal sounding music that really comes out of that particular genre. So why is it that I think particularly that, you know, metalheads could potentially get involved as a fan of classical music? Well, in my opinion, it goes back to one of my previous classical conversations that we did about why classical music is so important in this world today. You know, classical music, it's really one of the first true modern genres of music there was when we were starting out back in the 1700s and all that stuff, when the United States first came around. In fact, it really also originated internationally as well, you know. Classical music, with all the music that's usually made and all the importance of the pieces that were made, you know, it became a major influence to multiple genres, and metal and rock in itself are two of those genres that really come to my mind as two of those that are really of most importance, because a lot of the importance in regards to the classical music genre has played a major influence in the rock and metal industry as well. I say this because musicians in the metal and rock genres, they are influenced by classical music themselves. You know, there are a couple of bands where I know of that, you know, have like a piano player in there, you know, or even, you know, like some metal bands that really have like a cellist or maybe like, you know, like a violinist or something like that. You know, there are some rock songs that I know of out there that have a classical music influence in there. Take for example The Verve. In 1997, they did a song called Bittersweet Symphony, and it was one of the most popular songs there was in America during that time. And really because of that, it had a major mixture of not just punk rock but also classical music, because, you know, there was a lot of classical music sound in that particular song as well. And that's why I think that song was so popular back then, and it's really because of its major influence from the classical music genre. And some of the metal musicians themselves, they have really deep soprano and tenor vocals as well, you know. A lot of them have those kinds of vocals that would really be more associated with classical music, and, you know, that's mostly going into those, like, in the international metal scene, you know, stuff like that. And so classical music has played a major influence there as well. And of course, a lot of those bands as well, you know, they may have a cellist and a violinist as well. I remember a band called Yellow Card, in which they actually had an instrumentalist in that band that was actually a violinist as well. You know, he would play the violin while everybody else was playing their usual rock instruments like the guitars and the drums and all that stuff. So I found that to be really unique and creative when it came to that band, that they incorporated a violinist in that band. And really, you know, there's a lot of bands out there in the rock and music genre that have been really influenced by classical music. But I know what you're thinking. You're like, metalheads, why would they become fans of classical music? I mean, like, why would they really see themselves as fans of this? They'd rather be more into that, yeah, let's go smash up stuff and all that stuff and stuff like that. Why would they ever find themselves affiliated with classical music? music and all that stuff, when it's not something that really they would be that of that particular interest. Well, I think there are a few reasons why I think metalheads really can get involved as a fan of classical music. Number one, as I said before, metal and rock, just like other genres, they are heavily influenced by classical music. A lot of the sound that you hear today comes from that particular genre, and a lot of musicians from themselves, they have probably at some point in time, you know, played an instrument that was really like associated with classical music. Heck, even if it's just regular like acoustic guitar or something like that, or maybe even like a regular electric guitar during that time. Heck, we did a commission with a guy that plays an electric guitar back in April. You know, even those instruments themselves, they are heavily influenced by the classical music scene. And for those metal fans that are influenced by classical music, you know, it's something that they can get into because they know how important it is in today's world. They know that, you know, classical music can really play a vital role in regards to developing the next major musicians in any sort of genre, not just in rock and metal. And so obviously I do feel like that, you know, like that's a good reason why metalheads could particularly become fans of this particular genre. Another reason is because, you know, they feel like that, you know, it's something that's out of their comfort zone. You know, usually most metalheads, they would really just go in there with those mosh pits, you know, and just go crazy and all that stuff. In fact, a lot of metalheads themselves, they would do a lot of real crazy things as well. You know, like drinking a lot of energy drinks and all that stuff, and then just go crazy while at a concert and really just jump on stage or something like that. Yeah, I know classical music concerts may not be like that, but still, it can be a lot of fun as well. And I say that because you hear these pieces that musicians play on stage, like those from Tchaikovsky and Mozart and Beethoven and those composers and stuff like that, you know. You hear these types of songs that are being played by an actual symphonic orchestra, and it can feel like that, you know, like at times, like once that beat drops, you know, and it really gets to that major movement and all that stuff, it can feel like a mosh pit of their own, you know. Obviously, I wouldn't say that that's the case because, you know, obviously, it's usually an area where it's not known to happen. I mean, classical music concerts, they're not supposed to have mosh pits like that. So yeah, I mean, it's kind of weird that you really feel like that would be some sort of influence as a fan, but metalheads can really get involved as a fan of classical music because, you know, it can really get them out of their comfort zone. And in a way, just like the mosh pits that you usually see at metal concerts, they can feel like they're really doing a mosh pit of their own once that major movement starts to occur. Finally, I think the most important reason why metalheads can become real fans of classical music is because they get to meet new people. They get to learn something new. And really, they get to have a better understanding as to why this genre is so important to every single genre there is in this world, especially metal and rock. You know, because there's always something in this genre that can really become of major influence in future musicians. You know, they can meet those people, like, you know, all those that were around this genre for a while. Like, you know, the older generations, like the Gen X's and the baby boomers that have listened to classical music for such a long time, or even grew up with it during their lives. Like, there are even some people that are a part of a younger generation, like in my generation, Gen Z or the late millennials and stuff like that, that really grew up with classical music themselves. Heck, I know of a couple of colleagues that I work with at the symphony that are longtime listeners of classical music. They've been heavily influenced by it and have been musicians themselves. I can tell you, there are a lot of people as a metalhead that you can meet that you can learn a lot about their particular genres. You know, after metal, most other genres that they mostly associate themselves with are either pop, R&B, or maybe even, you know, like rap and something like more soft, like country and stuff like that. However, not classical music. But hey, with classical music, they can meet people and learn something new in regards to this particular genre. Trust me, there is something that can be really interesting for everyone, especially metalheads, when you learn about this genre. Now again, metal, it's probably one of the most electrifying genres of music there is, you know. All the mosh pits, all the heavy metal that's going on stage, and all the craziness that's happening in the crowd as well. It can really be an exciting time when you're a fan of that genre. But again, just like other genres, it is heavily influenced by classical music. And although metalheads may not have that much of a taste of classical music, all you have to do is bring them to one or two classical music concerts, and trust me, they can gain a real interest in that genre and understand why it is so important in today's world, and why it is a major influence in rock and metal today. And I think they can become real fans of that genre very quickly. I mean, it really depends on their taste. I mean, if there are those that go to a concert once in a while or in classical music and they decide they don't like it because, you know, it's not really their type, then hey, that's totally fine. But hey, there are some fans like me that are diehard fans of metal that are also fans of classical music. Trust me, when I started working at the symphony, I knew nothing about classical music. But after a few months of concerts and getting to do duty there, I've really come to really appreciate how important this genre is. So if you are a metalhead and you really enjoy metal and rock music, classical music is a major reason why that genre is here today. And I know of a lot of metalheads out there that I can personally believe will become real fans of this particular genre because of its influence in life and its influence in metal. So there you go, that's my conversation for today. I know that pop, R&B, and country fans, those kinds of fans would probably be a little more associated with classical music because of its influence there, but not metal. But again, I know of metalheads that can become fans of classical music themselves. So I want to hear from you, those that are fans of rock and metal. Are you personally a fan of classical music yourselves? And what is it about this genre that really intrigues you? Let me know about that in the comments below, and I'll be more interested in hearing your opinions about it. Anyways, that's going to do it for this video. I hope you all enjoyed it. As always, if you'd like to see more of my content, be sure to subscribe, hit the notification bell so you know my latest video is released. Comment below for future suggestions for all my videos, whether it's vlogs, projects, or challenges, you name it, leave it in the comments below, I'll do my best to make them. And as always, follow me on my social media, all the links are in the description below. That's going to do it for another midweek upload. I hope you're having another great day. And as always, I hope to see all of you again in another video very soon. So long, everybody.